All right, number one, we did on the bell work. Put an X right here. Put your dots. So it's going to be 11 squared plus X squared equals 18 squared. You're going to subtract 11 squared from this, and then you're going to take the square root. So on your calculator, I think this is 121. So 18 squared minus 121 equals shift square root. I get 14.2. Now, if you look at your choices, I don't see 14.2. So work each one of these with your calculator until you get 14.2. Does anybody know which one it is? It's this one? All right, so let's try that one. So press 203, shift, square root, and it is. Any questions on what I said or what I did on Pythagorean's theorem? Don't miss those. Okay, next. This one is the same way. Put your dots. I don't want to spend a lot of time, but it's 15 squared plus 20 squared is equal to x squared. So you're going to add up 225 plus 400, and that's going to give you 625, and then you're going to take the square root of that to get rid of that square, and you're going to get 25. So it should be this one. But some people are saying the answer is wrong, but that's the one I would go with. Next, use Pythagorean's theorem. So look up here. I'm only going to work one of these. So put 14 squared plus 48 squared equals 50 squared. Now, take your calculator. 14 squared is 196. 48 squared is 2304. Add up the 196. I get 2500 on this side. On the other side, 5 times 5 is 25, so 50 squared is also 2500. Now look here at the choices. If they are equal to each other right here, then it's a right triangle. So on your test, I want this, and then I want you to say a right triangle. Now, let's say I work this one because I click the button and it changes, and instead of 2500 on this side, I get maybe 3000. So now this side's bigger. If the hypotenuse side is bigger, then it would be obtuse. It would be this one. So if this right side, the hypotenuse, is bigger, this one would be obtuse. Is everybody clear on the concept? If they're equal, it's a right triangle. If the hypotenuse side is bigger, it's obtuse. If the other side is bigger with the legs, then it's acute. All right, flip it over. This one right here, you had to memorize 1, 1, square root of 2. So put your circles. It says, find the length of the hypotenuse. Does anybody know which one is the hypotenuse, the upper one, the left one, or the right one? All right, the left one, because the hypotenuse is opposite the 90. It's the biggest. So put an X here. So 1, 1, square root of 2. Square root of 2 is the biggest, so that goes across from the hypotenuse. So we're looking for, let's see what's going on. This should be a 1. So it's going to be 1 over 3 square root of 2 equals square root of 2 over X. Circle over this, circle over this. So I get X equals this times this. Put a 1 right here. 3 times 1 is 3. 2 times 2 is 4. The square root of 4 is 2, and 2 times that 3 is 6. So 6 should be your answer on that one. Any questions? We've been working on those a while, so don't miss those, okay? All right, the next one is a 30, 60, 90. I'm going to skip this one because it's the same deal. In fact, it's the same problem. All right, look at number 7. Draw a 30, 60, 90 triangle. Now, look here. It says the hypotenuse is 4. So do I put the 4 at the top, the right, or the bottom? Make sure you know that the hypotenuse is opposite the right angle. So this is your 4 right here. Now, you're looking for the perimeter. So you got to find this one and you have to find this one. Perimeter means you got to add up all the sides. So you had to memorize 1, 2, square root of 3. And 2 is the biggest. So put a 2 right here. Across from the 30, put a 1. And across from the 60, put the square root of 3. The problem with this one is you got to work it twice and then add it all up. So it's a lot of work. But oh well. So you're going to put your circles on top. So 2 over 4 equals 1 over y equals square root of 3 over x. You're going to use this one right here to find y. So this is an easy one. So you get 2y equals 4, divide by 2, and you get y equals 2. So right here you have a 2, you have a 4. All I need is this last one and then add them up. Well, the last one, you're going to use this one and this one. So put 2 over 4 equals square root of 3 over x. Now cross multiply. So you get 2x equals 4 square root of 3, divide by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2, so you get 2 square root of 3. So you want to add up 4 plus 2, 4 plus 2 plus 2 square root of 3. This is your answer, but you got to work it out. So clear your calculator. It's going to be on video, so if I'm going too fast, just watch it a million times. So press 3 shift square root times 2, press equals, and then plus 2, and then plus 4. If I did it correctly, I have 9.5. So I want to pick out the answer choice that gives me 9.5. You know which one it is? Yeah, you could, which is 6. It would be B. Okay. All right, but this is how I would do it, and then I would work backwards. So B, he's saying it's just easier just to do it that way, and yeah, that's pretty good. All right, next page, number 10. See, this is 30. This has to be 60. Now, you're going to have to memorize that. This has to add up to 90. 30 and 60 adds up to 90. So this is a 30, 60, 90 triangle. I tried to teach you alternating interior. That's what these are. All right, but you can do it this way. These are called complementary because they add up to 90. All right, and then put your circles. You had to memorize 1, 2, square root of 3. 2 is the biggest, so that goes here. Across from the 30 goes to 1, and the cross from the 60 goes to square root of 3. So on your test, you're going to say 1 over x equals square root of 3 over 18. And then you're going to cross multiply. So you get 18 equals x square root of 3. But then you got to divide by the square root of 3. So you get 18 divided by the square root of 3 is your answer. And since I want it as decimal form, just use your calculator. All right? But if you don't know how, then rationalize. So I end up with square root of 9, and the square root of 9 is 3. So I end up with 18 square root of 3 over 3, but 3 goes in 18, 6. So I get 6 square root of 3. That's the real answer, 6 square root of 3. And then use your calculator. Any questions on what I did? I only have a few more minutes, so watch. Again, sorry I'm going so fast. We're looking for the longest side. Well, this is the biggest angle. So the longest side has to be that one. You can't go by the drawing. It says right here, not to scale. So you can't go by that. 66 is the biggest angle, so this is the biggest side. Is everybody clear on that? This one right here is the smallest angle, so this is the smallest side. So you would say, they want to know from shortest. So JL should come first. So JL is here. I guess that's JL. This one is JL. This one's not. This one's not. So it's got to be one of these. But the biggest is KL. So KL is right here. So I would go with that one. Any questions on what I said or what I thought about or how I did it? It's not the scale. Number 12 works the same way, so I'm not going to do it. Number 13, look up here. I didn't teach you this one, but I'm showing you now, okay? I even gave you the hint. Add these two up. 10 plus that is 25. That's your upper limit. Subtract these two. 15 minus 10 is 5. So your number can be between 5 and 25. So it's got to be less than 25. That's what that is. I would just go with that one. Again, to get the upper limit, you add these two. To get the lower limit, you subtract these two. It's real simple. You add and subtract. You're just going to have to memorize it, okay? To get the third side of a triangle, you add them up. That gives you the upper. You subtract. That gives you the lower. I know I didn't show you that, but I'm showing you now. All right, here we go. Same thing here. What must it be? Add these up. I think that's 23. So the upper limit is 23. Subtract these two, and you get, I think it's 9. So it's got to be greater than 9, but less than 23. So here it is. Again, add them up to get the upper limit. Subtract to get the lower limit. All right, number 15, real quick, draw your triangle and then put 9x minus 7, put 7x minus 9, and then put 28 minus 2x. And then add all of these up and set it equal to 180. You have to find out what x is. Once you find out what x is, plug it in to each one of these to determine the biggest side. I'm going to say it one more time. Add all of those up. Set it equal to 180. Find x. Plug it back in. All right, this will be on video. That's pretty much your test. Good luck on Monday. Tomorrow is Carnegie.